All right, we are going to get started on our reading interactive notebook. So please grab our reading and grammar notebook and our plastic snap closure envelope. While you're doing that, I'm going to go grab the camera. We are going to need some glue and scissors and something to write with today as well. All right. So we're still talking about asking and answering questions. So this set that we have here, we need to take off the one that says answer match. It's yellow. And then we have another one. It's green and another one that's green. And then we're going to put these other ones away back in our envelope. Do we remember why we put it back in our envelope? What do I always say? A stitch in time saves nine. Go ahead and put it back so that when we need it tomorrow, you know right where it is. And you don't have to say, Mom, Dad, help me find my papers. I can't find them. I'm sure that never happens to anybody in our class, right? I've had it happen to me, so that's why I say it. Okay. We have, this is really giving us a lot of color in here, or a lot of glare. Okay. So we have one that says, why did Mira's family need potatoes? So we need that paper. We need the one that says, Mom forgot to buy them on the top there. And then we need this story, answer match. Okay. What we're going to do is go to reading. Okay. And we're going to go back to yesterday. We did restate the question. So we're just going to turn the page. And so that is just on the back. Okay, we're turning the page. And we are going to cut out our story, and we're going to cut out each of these boxes, okay? Oopsie. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and let you get started cutting, and I'll head over and turn on a little bit of music for you to listen to while you're cutting, and then we'll get it all glued in together, okay?
You know it used to be bad, so take a look what you've done.
All right. If you are not finished yet, go ahead and push pause so that you can get everything cut out. And then come back. All right. So go ahead and finish cutting out. When you're done, we have a pile of these smaller ones and we have the longer ones. Okay. We're going to put those to the side and we've got our story. So what I'd like you to do with your story is get our glue and roll it up, and we're just going to put some glue around the outside and cross in the middle. And we're going to put this up in this corner, almost to the top, but not quite, because we don't want it to be hanging out. Oh, mine's crooked. I don't like it to be crooked. Let me try again. Here we go. Okay, so get it all smoothed out. And then we're going to wait for just a moment, and we're going to read this story. So if you are not ready to read the story, please push pause so that you are ready. We can do it together. Okay. All right. It says, "Dang, I forgot to buy the potatoes for dinner tonight," Mira heard her mom say. Mira wanted to help. She grabbed a grocery bag and headed to her neighbor's house. "Do you have any potatoes that we can have for our dinner?" she asked when Mr. Jenkins answered the door. He gave Mira a sad look and went to the kitchen to grab the potatoes for her. Mira went to every house on her street asking for potatoes. She had so many that she had to bring them home in her wagon. Mira's mom looked surprised when she saw the filled wagon. Where did you get those? She asked. "I asked all of the neighbors to give us potatoes," Mira replied. Mom's face turned pink as she said, "I know that you wanted to help, but now all of our neighbors will think that we are too poor to feed our kids. It's embarrassing. We have to take them back." All right. Do you think that their neighbors probably felt that way? They probably didn't. They probably just said, "I'm happy to help." So we're going to start with number one. So if you will find number one, excuse me. Why did Mira's family need potatoes? Okay, we're going to glue that one in. Right up here, okay? So we want to have a little bit of room underneath. Why did Mira's family need potatoes? All right, now we're going to go grab these ones that have the little letters in the corner and find out which one is the correct one. Mira wanted to help her family. Mira went to every house on her street. Mom is embarrassed. They returned the potatoes. She had too many potatoes to carry. Mom forgot to buy them, which is the reason why their family needed potatoes. Which one do you think goes there? Mom forgot to buy them. All right. And hopefully we'll be able to get all the rest. So make sure you have that glued on that side. And now we're going to go to this page. All right. We need to get number two. Get a little glue on number two. I'm going to go up as high as I can get it to go without going out of the book. So high that you can't even see it. Okay. Why was Mira using her wagon? Okay. Because they returned their potatoes. Because mom is embarrassed. Because Mira went to every house on the street. Because Mira wanted to help her family. She had too many potatoes to carry. Which one do you think it is? Which one do you think would be the best answer? Why was Mira using her wagon? Okay, did you say because she had too many potatoes to carry. I'm going to glue that in really close, okay, because we're going to try to make room for all of them. All right. Go ahead and find those two. Okay, then you're going to look for number three. And we're going to go right in here with number three. What did Mom and Mira do with the potatoes? Okay, I'm going to grab my answers again. Mira wanted to help her family. Mira went to every house on her street. Mom is embarrassed. They returned the potatoes. Which one did they do? Which one do you think it is? Don't wait for me to answer. You can try. They returned the potatoes, didn't they? Okay. Go ahead and get that glued in. And we're going to go to number four. Why do they have to take the potatoes back? Was it because Mom is embarrassed, Mira went to every house on her street, or Mira wanted to help her family? Is it because Mom is embarrassed? Yeah. Oh, I hope I'm going to have enough room for everything. It's going to have to be really tight. Okay, make sure you get everything glued in. And when you're done with that, you're going to get number five. Put it up here. Close as you can get it. Where did Mira go to get the potatoes? Mira wanted to help her family. Or Mira went to every house on the street. Which one do you think answers the question? Did you say Mira went to every house on her street? You are correct. Hopefully you have just enough room for the last one. If not, can always turn the page if you have to. Or you can peel these off and reset them. The last question is, why did Mira go to all of her neighbors' houses? And our answer is, Mira wanted to help her family. I had to kind of leave a little corner up here. All right, let me back it up so you can see our book. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. What I could have done is put this question here and put the answer next to it, like, cross, but it's okay. All right, so make sure you have everything. Make sure you roll the glue back down so it's protected before you put the cap on it and snap it. Make sure you take all of your garbage and throw it in the trash can. We don't want to be leaving it anywhere out for Mom and Dad to have to pick up or anybody else. All right, and you are going to put that away. And you are all done with that. And you can head to our, well, let me see you first before I send you somewhere else. There you are. All right. So after we're done with this, you're going to head to our reading of Mouse and the Motorcycle, our read aloud chapter 8. Remember to pay attention to the questions, because that's where we'll find our question and answers for our reading questions of the day. And we don't have grammar today. I had said that already. And we do have social studies and science workbook. So, all right, guys, I'm going to head to our read aloud, and I will see you there.